Stella.
This is the 9th of April. This is a Maltese and Schnauzer mix. It's a spayed female, 3 years old.
Okay, what happened? What are you worried about?
The doctor, I brought her for spa.
Spa, when was it?
Spa.
Mud spa. When was it?
Mud spa about 2 weeks ago for her birthday time.
Okay.
So it has caused some rashes on the body. So I'm very concerned about rashes because I think she's feeling the itch.
Itchy, yeah?
Yeah.
Which part is itchy?
She scratched at the bottom lower portion of her body.
This part?
Yeah.
Below elbow?
Below elbow, yes, doctor. Below elbow.
Then some more? Any other area?
Then sometimes she tried to bite the back of her body.
Bite here, right? Bite the back side or bite here?
No, bite here.
Bite this.
Back side.
Then bite some more?
Then after that, sometimes she licked her private part. Because I think probably that area, sometimes she bite around that area. Probably it's itchy.
After the spa bath?
More predominantly after the mud spa.
But before that?
Before that, no doctor. Before that, sparingly lah. Maybe 1 month or 2 months once she does that lah.
She is sterilized, right?
Yeah, she's sterilized in this clinic, doctor.
Now, okay, so is she using the leg to do this?
Yeah, that's what she does.
She does, okay, she uses the leg to scratch the side. Normally it's the ear.
Okay. Ear infection.
Ear itchy. Okay. Infection are itchy. And that's why the dog does that. Both sides or one side?
Both sides, doctor.
Both sides.
One time, sometimes. Okay. Here is more predominant. Yes.
More predominant. So we check the ears. It's quite painful. Okay.
I'm a boy.
So you just hold the mouth.
Okay. I'm a boy. Good girl.
You see the reaction on there?
Yeah.
No, this one doesn't show much, but it's painful. What do you put inside the ear?
No, doctor, we don't put anything.
Okay, then.
We don't.
It's not dirty, but there's some pain there.
We don't put anything.
So we check the left ear.
I'm holding a.
This is a bit painful.
No, she won't.
Not a bit painful, yeah. No, I'm just seeing the pain.
Okay.
So, okay.
Come on, boy.
Muzzle first, hold the muzzle first.
Come.
Let's check the ear again, okay?
Checking the ear, ma.
So somebody do it, it's the groomer who does it, right?
Yeah, the groomer cleans the ear.
Is it every 2 months?
Every 2 months.
Okay, so something the groomer uses is not suitable for the dog.
Okay.
But I wouldn't know what the groomer uses. Just some ear drops. So they will explain that there's still some pain there.
Okay.
So what happens is that when it's painful, the dog does
start scratching here. So we thought it's
quite
itchy. Oh, doctor, a lot of time. It's like, we leave her to work. By the time we come back, about 6 o'clock. We are seeing her scratching.
So there's the ear painful. Painful but not infected, not painful.
Painful.
So the best is ask the groomer not to...
Yeah, ask them don't clean the ear. Okay, doctor.
Then I'll give an ear ointment which contains drugs to reduce the inflammation.
Okay, doctor.
So this part, you just use it for
right ear.
Both ear. Just put 5 drops in and then massage at least. Put 5 drops in.
Okay, massage is...
In the ear canal.
Massage this way.
Up and down, the ear canal, up and down.
Okay, doctor.
So that one will solve this problem.
Of her scratching, okay.
Okay. Then after that, you don't ask the groomer not to do it, but they have to do it because they always clean the ear.
Yeah. So no, I will tell them not to clean because it's a regular.
Pluck thing. The ear hair inside?
No, I don't pluck.
No, they don't pluck, okay. So that one explains it. Now, the second part you're talking about is here, right?
Yeah.
How it bites?
Try to turn her body and bite.
Bite here.
Around this region, doctor. No other
places?
Sometimes
below.
Below.
Okay, so normally the inner glands, when it's infected and full, which you will find that the dog feels that it's very itchy.
It
doesn't know exactly where. So you will find that the dog will bite here.
Oh, it starts biting all over.
Bite here.
Okay.
So that one just now expressed for you the inner. The oil.
Okay.
The oil, yeah. So the best is, of course, the groomer is supposed to do it now. But I guess your groomer doesn't
think so, doctor. I don't think so.
So that's why just now you saw. Now I just demonstrate for the video, but just now it was a lot.
Yeah.
Now I can feel that it's quite full also. So there'll be some more. Now groomers don't do it for some reason. I can't tell you why, but
many probably they are afraid, is it, doctor, that the dog
don't do it because they're afraid after the owner curse them and it's very painful. So you can see some oil coming out.
Yeah.
Well, I will press it again. It's very painful.
Is at the bottom? Is at the bottom of their anal.
You can't do it because the dog won't allow you to do it. But just now it squeezed
out. Yeah, it squeezed out already, doctor. There was a lot.
There's nothing much.
There was a lot just now.
So probably 100% come out. And every day they produce oil to mark the...
Mark the territory.
So in this case, it doesn't come out. The oil doesn't discharge.
So it gets stuck there.
Stuck there for many years.
Okay.
So you will see the dog running around in circles. Does he run in circles? Chasing the tail?
Yeah, she does chase the tail.
Tail chasing. These are the signs, inner sac. Tail chasing.
But not very often, doctor. She does run around.
Not very often because you are not around, you see.
Yeah, maybe I'm not seeing it. Yeah.
So now I explain to you. So they bite here, they bite here, they bite here. They don't know where they bite. They just know they have to bite somewhere.
Okay.
And in many dogs, you will see that there are two black spots here.
Because they keep on biting.
Because this is nearest to the inner glands.
Okay, doctor.
But your dog seems to be probably licking the tail. You can see the hair is gone.
Yeah, she does.
Lick the tail, you can tell the telltale clues, there are the clues here.
Yeah, okay, doctor.
So then, okay, so that one, once you see the tail biting or chasing, then either you do it or I do it or...
Can, doctor, I can bring it.
Okay.
Because I'm afraid.
Okay, so now the third thing we are talking about is here.
Yeah, the fungal, is that?
No, wait. So...
Okay.
We talked about the rashes on the lower part. Now, this shows that the dog, this part is normally, there's some hair. So it's rather hairless.
Mm.
This shows that the dog has been licking this part for some time.
Okay.
For some time. So, and also biting.
Yeah, so, biting there, yeah.
So the reason could be, it's a contact. Dermatitis where you contact the floor.
Contact the floor.
The floor has got chemicals, cleaning chemicals.
Okay, doctor.
And so, or your wool. You see there's a wool rug right from Australia.
Yeah, correct.
So the dog feels very itchy, so keep on licking until it's hairless, you see.
Yeah, it licks, doctor.
See? And it's not recently, it's many months or many years.
One more thing, doctor, we brought her to the veterinary. I think they shaved this portion down.
Veterinary to do what?
No, veterinary, the groomer.
She
cut her hair and shaved this portion down.
That time, were there any rashes?
There was all the while, doctor. The rashes were all the while there.
I thought it was treated last time?
Last time treated, doctor.
Okay,
it went off.
You can see there's some here, so there. Elbow.
Last time she treated, got.
Elbow, yeah.
Yeah.
These are the ones. How about the neck?
Neck, I'm not too sure,
okay,
doctor. Neck, I don't
know. Does he scratch his neck?
No, sometimes, doctor.
Okay.
Like this.
So this one. So we're talking about this ventral.
Lucky ma.
Ventral dermatitis. The solution is, they of course, don't let the dog lie on the something which
rug,
is irritating.
Okay.
We don't know exactly what.
Okay.
So if it's the rug, then it's very simple. Take away the rug.
Okay, doctor.
And then the other one is, owner they let the dog wear a
guard.
Sort of shirt or something. Yeah. And it protects here.
Okay.
Then of course the dog lies on the floor on the rug. Then there won't be any allergy. You see.
Okay, doctor.
But
sure.
I don't know whether you have such a clothing or not.
They have dresses. But
no, you must cover this part and this part.
Cover that portion. Okay.
So if not, then what we do is we treat it and then you take away the rug first.
Okay.
And then see whether any floor is wet. Does the dog like to go to the kitchen
no,
or toilet
does,
floor?
She go kitchen.
Where it's dirty and wet or oily, you see?
Yeah.
So let the hair grow back. Once the hair grow back, it's much easier for the dog. Okay, then the other, the last reason, the fourth reason, is the dog might have a bladder infection.
The last time round,
you can see it's reddish.
Yeah, doctor.
So she kept on licking her private parts.
Yeah.
And this bladder infection, as to what causes it, it's hard to say, but so this could be the cause of the licking, because she's trying to clean herself.
Yeah.
And then, so...
Previously, I treated her for some urine infection, doctor.
So the best is to have a urine test every now and then, monthly,
doctor.
If you can collect the urine.
Yeah, okay,
so they would let us know. Has she got blood in the urine?
No blood.
Was the urine test done before?
Yes, done.
Done before,
Yeah.
What was the result? Let me see.
Dr. Singh, the younger one, told us that it was okay, but got some viral or something like that.
No,
some
bacteria.
Some bacteria or something like that.
Yeah. I wrote down, take antibiotics 1 month later. Do you take antibiotics?
Yeah, the antibiotics we gave
September,
her.
It was August, yeah.
Yeah, we gave her, doctor. She took.
So there was bacteria.
The liquid
inside
form.
This shows that this dog has a urinary tract infection.
Okay.
for some reason.
How to cure it, doctor?
Does she drink a lot of water?
Yeah, she drank. She does.
Huh?
She does.
She does, so. How you know? Do you measure?
Because we see her. We see her. We put one tub full of water. When we come back in the evening, how many quarter left?
So we see the specific gravity is 1.029. It's okay. Yeah, there's some whatever cells. This is in August, 2013.
Yes, doctor.
Okay, so has another test been done?
No, after that, I don't think so. Any urine test was done. I wasn't, I'm not too sure.
Are you able to collect urine?
Yeah, I have to collect, doctor. I got your past records, yeah.
No, I'm for urine for testing.
Testing, can doctor. I do it now.
Let me check.
Because I see the thing red and my heart sink. No, you won't bite,
Painful.
Won't bite.
So there's some pain in the...
She'll just put the mouth like that and just take off. She won't bite.
No, I mean it's painful.
Yeah.
Now, how do you collect urine the last time?
The last time, you know her pee pen, doctor?
Oh.
The ladder urine the pee pen, because she always goes, she's toilet trained. She goes to the pee pen, she urine, and we collect from there.
Okay, so now in the meantime, we will do the treatment first. So
yeah.
The next time it comes when she keeps on leaking,
okay.
Then you collect the urine.
Can, doctor.
Oh.
So do I need to collect the urine this time, no? Do you want to do a culture of the urine?
Yeah, but how you collect? Because normally we catheterize.
Oh.
But I feel that the bladder is
a bit sore, right?
Painful, yeah.
Yeah.
Unless she has bladder stones. Or a small stone.
Okay.
So the best is the X-ray.
Okay.
X-ray first. So if there are bladder stones, at least we know.
Can doctor, why don't you do that?
No, I think that is the first thing to do.
Can doctor.
Okay, so X-ray. Because it's painful.
I think Dr. Singh recommended a radiography, you know.
He did not.
He did recommend it.
For the bladder.
For the bladder.
Bladder and kidney.
So he recommended the
radiography. Yeah. That was in January.
January this year.
So we do now?
Yeah. Can doctor.
Okay, so, okay, let's finish.